Okay, we're on Kuf Yud Gimel Amid Aleph. We are again in the middle of just very interesting, nice Gemara. A little more advice about different things, about different ideas in life, and people that HaKadosh Baruch Hu loves, people that HaKadosh Baruch Hu does not love. On Kuf Yud Gimel Amid Aleph, 113a for those people using Art Scroll. Thank you. You're welcome.
A1.
Okay. The second line from the top. Amale Rav Leravasi said, Rav Travasi, Loi Sidor Bimasa, do not reside in a city. The Loit son of Bei Susya, that there's no horse to bray. Loi Novach Bakalba, no dog to bark. Why would that be? Because again, a dog barking and a horse braying, the animals have senses. And therefore, if anyone's going to steal something, they're very, very, you know, they're very alert to it. And I just walked up to my daughter's house the other day, just walked on the porch, and my granddog started barking. Just, you know, very, very. So I heard a wonderful pshat over here. Wonderful, beautiful pshat from the Chassam Sofer. It says like this. It's a very odd thing we do. You know, the night of the Seder, it's a halig night, you know, holiest night of the year. Mamish Kedusha, B'taira, you're wearing the kitzel, you're pumped, the kids are pumped, everyone's pumped. What's the first thing you do? You teach the kid to steal. Go ahead, steal the Afikoman. What is this? You know, you teach the kid to steal. It's a strange thing. So the Chassam Sofer says something fascinating. He says that one of the nisim in Mitzrayim was b'cholaretz Mitzrayim la'yecharetz kerev l'shainai. They had dead dogs. So here's Klal Yisrael's emptying out Mitzrayim, emptying the gold and the silver and the money. They give Amish carrying everything out. And the dogs, nothing, zero, nothing, right? Zero, nothing. So says the Heliga, some Sefer, that's pshat. By stealing, we're showing that what? We're illuminating and magnifying the nest that occurred, that what? That no dog, in other words, you see from this Gemara over here, that what? That you don't live in a city where there's no dogs, because the dogs are a protection. So we're showing over there, despite they were dogs, right? The nest that no one opened their mouth, and we do the act of stealing, which would go ahead and engage the dog to actually go ahead and involve itself. So the story goes, the Chassav Sofer, his son, asked him the first night of the Seder, he asked him, why do we steal? You know, why are we stealing? He asked the Kasha, and he didn't answer him. And then the second Seder, they got to that point, and he asked him again. And then he told him the same thing. So he said to him, says, you know, Tati, Rebbe, Abba, I'm sure he didn't call him Daddy. He said, like, what? The first night I asked you didn't answer, and now you're answering? So he goes, first night I wanted to teach you a lesson. The reason you do a mitzvah is you do a mitzvah. You don't have to understand the reason. You don't have to understand the reason behind it. The mitzvahs are, I always speak about the Gzeres HaMelech. You do it because Hashem tells you to do it. Now that we answer the mitzvah, Rebbe L'chayra, the second night, okay, now I'll tell you the reason. Very nice story, nice addition to this little Gemara. The Reish Masa asks you, do not live in a city where the head of the city is a doctor. He's going to be so busy with his roife, with doing his refuas, he won't have time to do his administrative duties. We saw this the other day, yesterday, in fact, right? Don't live in a city where the head of Tamidei Chachamim, they'll be busy learning, right? You won't be busy out with community affairs. But Tinosiv Tarti, don't marry two women. Why? Because they're going to go ahead and conspire against you. So you nasiv tarti, nasiv klas. Get the third one. Maybe the third one will tell you what's going on. Obviously, before the Chayim Rabbeinu Gershon. What? Maybe not. You get three is yeah. Anyway. Okay. Anyway. Only Rav Rav Kahana said Rav to Rav Kahana, hopich benivlasov leitepich b'mili. Go ahead and literally, you know, turn over in a vela. Not a nice thing. Leitepich b'mili, but keep your word. Don't go ahead right and change. You know. Keep your word. Don't change your word. Your word should mean something. Push it in a velasa, right? You should go ahead and skin a nevela, shuka publicly. The shakal igra get paid for that. Don't say kahana. I'm Rav Kahana, but gavra rabba. I know, and I'm a gavra rabba. Sanya be milsa, and it's very wide. It's beneath my dignity. No, there's nothing beneath your dignity. You know, we got some tremendous. I'm talking about Yochanan Sandler. He was a shoemaker, and it was Reichen and Amira was a blacksmith. You know, the people they did the work. They learned. They did work, and anyway, huge Talmud Chacham, He knew every shagas ayah b'hat. Really, and came to America. And he was a car mechanic for a while. He was a car mechanic. You walk in, he's a car mechanic. I knew. He was a guy. He was a car mechanic. You know, go get Frank's conscious. Says Gemara, Salakis le'igrach, go up to the roof, and Sheirusach ba'adach. If you're going up to the roof, meaning if you're going on a trip, if you're going anywhere, make sure you have bread with you. Make sure you have food with you. This is where the Jewish thing comes in. We always have food. Ne'ya kari b'masa b'zuzah. Even if 100 gourds are sold in the zuz and get it cheap, always keep something with you. Tutu k'nech le'navi. Always keep something underneath what? Your cloak. Always have some food with you. Like I have a friend of mine, he told me when you go to Israel, you have to have a Danish. You always have to have something with you, you know, whatever. You have two Danishes, you get stuck for a few hours, you're good, you know? So since that, anytime I go fly to Israel, even for my passport, they're sticking at that Danish. Good Rebbe. I'm a Rav Lechia Berei. Said Rav Lechia Berei, Leitishti Sama, don't drink drugs. Now, this is fascinating. Guys, when did the Rashbam live? When did Rashbam live? In the 12th century, in the 1100s. He was Rashi's grandson. Lamish lived in the 12th century. He says, don't drink drugs. Look how he explains this. It's unbelievable. It's the fifth line down, where it gets the Rashbam, fifth line down. Leitishti sama, al tishti samim. Back, listen to this. Al tishti samim, if nation nikvav lehem veset. They become fixed in you. Like a vessel is a set time. You become addicted. And your mind is going to want it all the time. And you spend all your money on it. I feel refuah, like tishti. Even for refuah, you should take it. Right? Isn't that fascinating? Unbelievable. He describes addiction. You get addicted. It's going to be a veset. A veset means a set time, right? A veset. You're going to have to take it all the time. So therefore, stay away from that. That was the advice that Rav gave to Rav Chia Berei. Another piece of advice: the leitishvar nigra, don't take a big step because a big step takes away what part of your eyesight. Or don't go walk over a puddle, right? Don't walk over. Well, it's another shot. They would go walk over puddles. If you have a toothache, don't uproot your tooth, it'll go away. Don't go ahead and fool around with snakes. Don't go ahead and provoke a snake. And I'm a guy, don't provoke the guy. There are three people or three things you shouldn't fool around with. Don't provoke them. Elohim, Nachri Cotton, the Nachash Cotton, the Talmud Cotton. They all grow up, and my time, what's the reason? The Malchusayu Achure Adnayu, the Malchus is behind their ears. Basically, Koi, when they're going to get older, they're going to remember. Says Rashbam, Malchusayu Achure Adnayu Kaimi Kloimar, a seed in the Godel. In the future, they're going to get bigger. Bittigodle Muslim, and then they're fear, and then they'll take revenge from you. They'll eventually take revenge from you. So Amale Ravla Evoy Bray. Now, so he had two sons, Rav. He had a son of Chia, who was a big Talmud Chacham, and his son had Evoy. This is the only time in Shas Evo appears. Rav Chia appears all the time. This is the only time that he appears. And what does he say? Tarachni b'cha b'shmaitza. And he tried to learn. Lame mistayim milsa. You weren't successful. Te agmarcha mili da alma. Let me teach you something, right? I'll teach you business acumen. So, chanoich lana al pidarka, right? You're going to go ahead. He didn't make it in learning. Now he's going to teach him what to do in business. What does he teach him? When the stand is still on your feet, zavinach sovin, sell your merchandise. Right? In other words, you went ahead, you imported something, you went out, you got something, you bring it back. So there's two ways of business. You keep it until it becomes more scarce and goes up in price, or what? You sell it now at a cheaper price. Said Rav, sell it now at a cheaper price. You get Rashbam explains, you'll get your cash flow, you'll get your money now, you'll be able to buy more schreira, more schreira, more schreira, and deal with volume. Zavin kol mili zavin b'ticharet. If you sell anything, you can regret it if it goes up in price. Bami chamre, if you sell chamre, the zavin v'le ticharet. If you sell it, don't have any charata. Why? Because again, it could have spoiled. Shari kisach, open your purse, and psach sakech. And then put your what? Open your purse to take the money from the person. And afterwards, put what? Whatever he gives you, put it in the sack. In other words, get paid first before you provide the merchandise. Kaba me'ara v'le kura me'igra. kura is 180 times more than a kava. So a kav, sell something for a kav me'ara in your own land, meaning immediately, like kura me'igra, don't go to a different place, go up to the roof for a kura. So set tamra b'chalusach, if you have a tamra, a date in your basket, lebeis sudnik, go right away to the brewery, royet and run. You had kama, how much do you have to have in the basket? So amarava atil sasa, even as little as what? As three saw. And that's why, because you're worried, you may come to eat it before you brew them, there's more money in brewing them. Amra papa, Eloi de Rami Shikra, if I didn't go ahead and become a brewer, Loi Atri, I wouldn't have gone ahead and become wealthy. So Rapapa was a wealthy man as a result of being one in the brewery business. He's got his wealth. Ikadi Ami, Amra of Chista, it wasn't Rapapa, but Rav Chista. Eloi de Ramoi Shikra, Loi Atri. If I didn't go ahead and brew, again, they made date beer, fellas, date beer. Loi Atri, I wouldn't have got wealthy. My Sudna, when it says that Sudna, what's the lashon of Sudna, a brewery? So I'm Rav Chista, it's a good secret. We can give this chasadim and it can be going with chesed because it doesn't involve a lot of karen and you can give it to aniyim. It doesn't involve a big amount of expenditures. So I'm Rav Papa, kol agav givia boi, any bill needs to be collected, and kol ashroi, any sale that was on credit, suffik asi, suffik layasi, it's a suffik whether it's going to come, get paid back or not. In other words, if you have a bill, you have a bill, it's credited. Again, this is for credit cards. With the Aussie, and sometimes it gets paid back, Mois Royce, you know, it's bad money. If so often people, they pay back and they pay back piecemeal. So you never get back. You lend the person $5,000. He pays you back $100 a month. You'll never see the $5,000 because you just, that's called Mois Royce. It's paid back in a way that you don't enjoy. You get a payback issue. Banks can afford to go get $100 a month because they get it from a million people. Mashenkin, a regular person who goes ahead and lends a person money, gives a person a loan, he really can't afford to go ahead right and do that. You could do it, but again, you're not going to see that. You're not going to at any time have your money altogether again. Gimel Devarim, Am Rabbi Yochanan B'Shem Anshei Yerushalayim. Three things Rabbi Yochanan said in the name of Anshei Yerushalayim. Kishata Yitzil Melchama. Now this doesn't seem to me to be the biggest, smartest thing, but here's what it says. When you go out to war, I'll Tetzei B'Rishana, don't be the first guy out. Yeah? Ella Tetzei B'Rishana, be the last guy out. Kidei Shetikonis B'Rishana. Because what happens if you're losing? So you'll be the first one back in. V'asei Shabbat Chachoyal V'atitzorach L'Bias, Rabbi Kiva said the same thing. Make your Shabbos Choyal, in other words, don't make huge expenditures on Shabbos that you have to come out to people. And finally, V'amishadal in Misha Hashah, with a person that what the show is, misachik. In other words, he's a guy you see as mazel, he's a person you should invest with. I'm a Rebbe Shloisha Dvar. What?
Anything you buy with
Shabbos, you missed yesterday's share. Right, yeah. Okay, take a look at Tosfos. I say Shabbat and Chabbat, the Sarach Labrias, Vahadar Mina, Perik Beis, the Bitsa, the Bahitsa, Shabbos, Yom Toivim, and Poikas, Poikas, and Loi. If you spend less, you'll get back less. That's if it's your own money. But to borrow money, we don't say that, Mordechai. If it's your own money, you spend. Borrow money to do it, that we don't say. Okay. Just remember yesterday, we said a beautiful diak of the Ben Yehoyada. It doesn't say, make Shabbos choyl. Chas v'sholom. Like historically be. Don't come up to the people. Shabbos, go to work. Chas v'sholom. Shabbat cha. Your chiyuv of oinik Shabbos, your chiyuv of kavod Shabbos make choyl. That's lashon Shabbat cha versus Shabbos, right? Shabbos you can't make choyl. Shabbat cha, your chiyuv Shabbos, you could make choyl. It's the Ben Yehoyada, very beautiful diak in the word, the difference between Shabbat cha and Shabbos. Okay. I'm a Rebbe. Shloish to the Varim Amar Rabbi Yeshua Ben Levi, Mishum Anshei Yerushalayim, Al Tarbe, it can't be Rebbe, because it can't be Rebbe. Anyway, he was before Yeshua Ben Levi. So let's shleish the dvar of Rabbi Yeshua ben Levi mishum Anshei Yerushalayim. Al tarbe begonos or begagos. Don't go ahead what and look from the roof or on a roof or an open area. Mishum Maisa Shahaya. The old Maisa of David Batsheva. David was on the roof and he noticed Batsheva getting ready to go to the mikvah. She was washing herself and that put into action the whole Maisa with David and Batsheva and Uriah. Of course, anyone who says David was chayte and altaya, we went through this many times. I'm not going to spend time on it now. When Sefer Shabbos, we did a nice arichas on it. There's a tape on it. It's all taped if you ever want. Really, it's all on tape. Anyway, so the Maisa Shahaya, Bitcha Bagra. If your daughter becomes a Bageris, guys, 12 and 6 months. If your daughter becomes a Bageris, Shachra Avdacha Betainla. Don't wait around. Even free your Eved Knaini, that he should become a Jew, and give her to her, him. You marry that daughter off as soon as you can. Be very careful with your wife from your first son-in-law. My timer, you got to worry about Erva, Rav Kahana Mishum Mamin, right? And both you have to worry about. That first son-in-law you have to worry about. I'm Rabbi Yochanan Shlosha, Menachli Olam Haba, the three people who are in Olam Haba, Elu Hain, Hador Eretz Yisrael, you live in Eretz Yisrael, Vamagadl Bonal Talmud Torah, someone raises his children to Torah, and Vamavdal Al Yayin B'Moitzah Shabbos, someone who's Mavdal on Yayin Moitzah Shabbos, Maihi, what's the big deal? Everyone does that. The Mishtaya Mikdusha Lav Dalta, he has so little wine, and he wants to enjoy it on Shabbos, but what does he do? He doesn't drink up the whole thing, and he saves from Moitzah Shabbos for Havdalah. So he's giving off himself for Havdalah, he's Zoychet Olam Haba. I'm Rabbi Yochanan, Shleishim Achriz Nalei Makadosh Baruch Hu Chol Yoyim, Be HaKadosh Baruch Hu is Machriz, he calls out every day,
Good?
Going good, yeah, good. So, who are they? Ravok. Hador Bikrach, Rabbi is a panoi, he's a bachelor who lives in a city with a many women. Veina chayta, v'al oni hamachse avedu l'baylaha, an oni that would have a taiva to keep what a chayfetz, but he returns it. V'al osher hamase peiros bitzina, and an osher who goes ahead and he takes off his peiros bitzina. Beis Yosef, the Anan Yosef says there are three things that cause a person to misgaber on taiva. Snus, mamin, and kavod. Those are three types, guys. Snus, mamin, and kavod. Snus, mamin, and kavod. Right? Those three. So keneged the snus, we have the ravok. Keneged the mamin, we have the ani. And keneged the kavod, we have the usher. He doesn't look for kavod. He's just doing everything clandestinely. So those three things, the makos are keneged the three things that a person is misavah for. Very nice pshat. Yeah. Rav Safra, in fact, was a Ravak. He was a bachelor. Hadobe Krachavi, he lived in a Krach. And Tony Tanaka made the Rav and Rav Safra. So a reciter of Bryce said over this memra in front of Rav and Rav Safra. And so who pondered Rav Safra? Rav Safra was beaming. He was beaming. Well, look, I'm machos that I get to Olam Haba because why? Because I don't indulge in immorality. So Amalei Rav says, Rav, love kigai mar. Not so fast. Listen to this. They were shoemakers. Yeah, the great Rav Chanina and the great Rav Oishia were what? They were shoemakers. But Ardi Yisrael, Rav Yossi Bishuka is Zionists, and their shoe shop happened to be in the shuk of Zionists. That was their job. But Avdilu Masani Lizinus, in fact, they would make the shoes for the Zionists. But Ayilahu, Inu, and Mistakli, they would go up the Zionists and they would look at Rabbi Shem Chanina. The Inu, like Madli and Ayilus, look at them. They never lifted their eyes to look at them. Umaysainu Hachi. And when they would make a shvua, the Zionists would make a shvua, they would say, Bechaye and Rabbon and Kedisha Dar Yisrael. We're making the shvua in the name of the Rabbon and Kedisha Dar Yisrael, referring to Rabbi Shem and Rabbi Chanina. Those are what Kodesh Baruch Hu's makos. Why they couldn't move their location? Fragments can't cash this, right? Right?
Location.
Yeah, I guess location, right? Well, by the way, people came up there for, I saw do their shoes also, right?
Oh, he made shoes for the Zionists. And I mean, that was his business. He made shoes to get the services. He made shoes for them, right?
I don't think that was his whole, sole business. Excuse the pun. Anyway, so...
Soul business.
You got it. Anyway, says the Gemara Vayta. Shloisha Kodesh Baruch Hu Oyevan. There are three that Kodesh Baruch Hu loves. Mishen Akoyes, a person doesn't get angry. Umishen Mishtaker, a person doesn't get drunk. Umishen Maimin Al Midaisa. And a person who's not Maimin Al Is Midais. A person who doesn't hold a grudge. A person who's not such a mamish, One of the things I I noticed throughout life, to let go of a grudge is not the easiest thing to do. And everyone in life has a reason to go ahead, Rod, and hold a grudge. I'm not taking this part. Remind me to... okay, we're recording. Okay. Mamish, Kadosh Baruch Hu loves you. If that Shleisha Kadosh Baruch Hu, I have him. Mishena Koyas, Mishena Mistak, and Mishena Maimon Al Midbeisav. Shleisha Kadosh Baruch Hu Sainim. Three Kadosh Baruch Hu hates. Amadabra Echad Bepev Echad Belev. Right? You say one thing, you mean another thing. You're not universally true. You're not true. But you're there, Edis Bechaveroi. Ve'ena Meidloi. You know Edis for your friend and you don't testify. Hashem hates that. Baroya Devar Erva Bechaveroi. You see your friend doing an Avera Devar Erva. Who made by Yechidi, and you come and you made Yachid. Now, the guy did the Avera, guys. The guy did the Avera, but Al Pishnai made him Yachim Dover. Wow. Anyway, so the if you go ahead and you made Yechidi, all you're doing is speaking Lashon Hara because you didn't accomplish anything. No, you know, person can't do anything. So why do you go, this guy is an immoral jerk. I mean, what are you saying? You know, what are you saying? You know, Hashem hates that, right? And a very famous story, says the Gemara. Tuvia went ahead and did an Avera and came along Zigud alone and he testified against him in front of Rapapa. So Nagdik the secret, Rav Papa gave malchus to the Aedis. Amalei, very famous line. Tuvia chata v'zingud mangit. Tuvia did the Avera and Zingud's getting malchus, getting zing. Right. Amalei, in v'chsev layakam eidecha de'ish. Right. V'at l'chudcha asad bey. Shame Rabba Alma kam afkas bey. All you're doing is being moved to shame on this guy. In other words, if you're not going to accomplish something, now, so I'm Rav Shmuel bar Yitzchak, I'm Rav. Mutalis nicely, you permitted to hate the guy. No, it's good. In other words, you shouldn't go ahead and hate your friend. You can hate this guy. The guy's a Russia, you can hate him, but you can't testify against him. You can hate him, but you can't testify against him. If you see your donkey of your friend, it's buried underneath its load, it's lying there. Right, and you should help him. Right, my son. What son are we talking about over here? My son, Nachri, Ivor Tanya, son Yisrael, son Yisrael. It's not a son guy. It's a son Yid. Play son Nachri. El Pshita must be son Yisrael. Now, but still, you shouldn't hate your friend in your heart. So how can you go ahead and hate him? Ella, it must be Dick Asadi, David Isura. So it must be that what he is found guilty. In other words, two people testified against him. Now, if two people testified against him, no, it's not Sonacha. It's not unique to you. If a guy's a Russia, he's a universal Russia, yeah? Guys, Sonacha means he's hated by you, but not by anybody else. If he's a Russia that two people testified against, then everyone hates him because he's a Russia. So it must be that what? So my Shnohai, El Alav, it must be Kiya Gavna, the Chazi Be'ihu, the Bar Erva, this guy saw the Bar Erva. And therefore you testified against him. And this is right. And therefore you're permitted to hate him. So Rav Nachman Yitzchak Amar, mitzvah l'snoisei. Not only you're allowed to hate him, it's a mitzvah to hate him. It says, Yiras Hashem, sonata ra. Those who haters of evil are Yiras Hashem. Amar Bacha Bari, the Rav al Ravashi. Ma'olim emalei l'rabbi l'masnik. Can you go ahead and tell your Rebbe to hate this guy? In other words, you're not allowed to say Lashon Hara. You're allowed to tell your Rebbe to hate this guy. Amalei, yodad v'mehim l'rabbi. If you know the Rebbe, if he's believed by his Rebbe, they trade like two lemalei. You could say it in below, like lemalei. Ayin hilchas lashon hara. Tan rabbanim. Shloisha chayeyim ein chayim. There are three people whose lives are not lives. Harachmanim, people who are too nice, they're too merciful. The harashchanim, and people who get angry. The inini hadas, and people who are very, very delicate. Those three people, their lives are not alive. But situationally, they're going to go ahead and be exposed to situations which are going to take away from them. Look at Rashbam. On the side, left, up, harachmanim yosemidai. In other words, you should be merciful, but not yosemidai. Vahani shloishemili dava hatada behem kol shah. These three things, being overly merciful and angry and situations of delicacy, the good stuff, right, is yovan kol shah. The kiv and the humakbit aleihem, since he's makbit, ein chayav chayim, she'ein lo menucha. In other words, he's always going to be affected by it. He's always going to be affected by it. A guy gets angry. I go to a store. There's a guy, I don't know how anyone goes to the store. I never saw the man smile. He's always angry. He's always angry. I want to ask the person working there, how do you work there? The guy's always angry. Really, it's amazing. But Rabbi Yosef, Kula Isnu B, says Rabbi Yosef, guess what? I got all three. I'm too overly merciful, I get angry too quickly, and I'm overly delicate. Tan Rabbanan, Shloisha Soinim Ze Ezeh, three hate each other. Elohein Klovim, dogs hate each other. If they're the same, if not a male, female, female, male, male, female, female. Right, Tan Gailim, right? Roosters hate each other. Right? Yeah, they fight. Roosters fight. The Chavarim, these are Chavarim, is a Persian sect. The Yishayimim, Afa Zaynes, they also hate each other. The Yishayimim, Af Tamid Chamashem Bavel hate each other. I don't know. Tanamanan, Shleisha Oivim Zezet. Three love each other. Elohein, Hagerim, Bavodim, Vorvim. Gerim, Avodim, and Orvim are ravens. Arbo, Ein Adas, Saivlason. Four, the Das cannot understand them. They can't be Saivlason. Elohein, Al Goya, a pauper that's a Balgaiva. Yosha Machesh, and a rich person who denies rich money that claims against him. The Zaki Minayev, and a dirty old man. Upanis Miskala Tzibur, and a right Bechinam, a guy who makes himself a boss. These four things that can't be Sibyl. Beishaimim Afim Megarish Asishtoi, Parmishaina Shneo Omachzira. And some others say he goes ahead, he brings his wife back, he divorces her, and he brings her back a second time. Tanakama, why doesn't he go ahead and consider this? The Das doesn't understand this because Zin the Ksuvasa Maruba, and that's why he takes her back because he can't afford to pay Ksuba. Inami Yeshle Bonami Mena, he has children from her, and therefore he takes her back. Vlemasi Megarishlo, Hamisha Devarim, Siva Kanan es Bonov. I don't know if they say Siva, but it's a trait that they carried over. If you see, look at the Rashbam, Siva Kanan es Bonov, Kloimar. I mean, Hogam Cain, who Kielat Siva Leim Aviem, if, right? Naftimina Shetzerach Adon Lizar Mehem. You got to be careful from them because these are traits that they have that were passed down from Kenan, their father, who had been cursed by Chum, the son of Noach. After the incident that what Noach did, Noach cursed Chum. He cursed Chum through his son Kenan. And what are these traits? That. Oyv is Zezet, they love each other. Oyv is the Gezel, they love to steal. Oyv is Azima, they love immorality. The son of Esad Nechem, they hate their masters. And after all, they are slaves. Val Tidabru Emes, and what? And they do not speak the truth. Shisha Dvarim, no! Politically correct at all times. Shisha Dvarim Nemru Bisus. 16 to say about a horse. Oyves as nus, they're very, very, very frisky horses. Oyves as muhammad, they love war. Right? For ruach, bruchay gasa, they're haughty. Umoyes as ashena, they don't love to sleep. For oichel harbe, they eat a lot. Umoyes kimba, they don't give out too much. They don't excrete too much. The yeshayim mamavak shlarik ba'olav b'muhammad, they also want to kill their master in war. They'll dilly dally around if they see another female, if they have to go to the bathroom, and they won't save their master. Shiva menudim l'shamayim. There are seven who are put in chayim l'shamayim. Elohein, Yehudi yishen l'isha, if he doesn't get married. U'sheyesh l'isha v'ein l'ibonim. We'll see Tysus in a second. U'misheyesh l'ibonim v'ein megalim l'talmud Torah. You have children and you don't megalim l'talmud Torah. U'misheyesh l'tfilin v'reishay, tfilin b'zroya, v'tzitzis v'bigdoy, u'mezuzah v'pischay, v'amoneh minolim v'raglo, he doesn't wear shoes. V'yashayim m'af misheyesh meisa b'chavur shal mitzvah, he's not, doesn't join in the chabura of mitzvah. Let's see Tysus, ein l'ibonim, second Tysus. Near a dafka ayudei pshiyasle. He has no children because of his pshiya. Shein misasek the pir v'rivya. He's not oisik in pir v'rivya. Tumi nachrina. Umishen like tefillin b'roishay ubezroya. This is a big day. Mari pshiyeshle. He has them. Veinam einichay. So ein leibana means he doesn't try to have children. And when it speaks about tefillin and tefillin and sittis, that's where he owns them and he doesn't put them on. Inami afilu ein lo. Even if he doesn't have. He should go ahead and try to bring himself to Chiyav. But the mitzvah is in Eretz Yisrael. What I mean in Tefillin, so you can go to Naki, Kolisha, Heinuk, and Farish, and you shouldn't go ahead and expel gas. B'shas kriya shema k'dei l'kabel of malchus shemayim shleima b'kal yochel yizor. You can be careful. Okay, very good. That's the Gemara Vayit. Amar Rabba Rav Chana, Amar Reb Shmuel Bar Marta, Amar Rav Mishum Rav Yoisi, Ish Hutzel, Minayin Shein Shoylem B'Kildayim. How do you know supposed to look at, Kildayim is astrologers. How do you know you're not supposed to go ahead and try to figure out the future? Shenema, because it says, Tomim Tiyev Hashem L'Kecha. You should be Tomim with Hashem. Hashem knows what's going to happen. Hashem is taking care of you. That's one of the things that the seven causes of bitachin in Perek Beis, Akshar Bitachin, is that Hashem knows what's best for you. And also, no good or bad can happen to you unless Hashem wants it to happen to you. So once that's there, to go ahead and look for futures is a lack of bitachin HaKadosh Baruch Hu. How do you know if your friend is greater than you in one thing? Even in one thing, Shneamar, it says by Daniel, Kol Makabel Di Ruach, Yaseira, because of the extra spirit of Chachma that was in Daniel, Umalkos is like Musa Yakomel Chusa. So Nebuchadnezzar, who showed him tremendous covet. By Yeshevas Adam Torah, Surah the Shamish, and someone who's Yeshevas Adam Torah is also the Tashmish at Kama, Omer Rav Oina. Okay, outside for a second, fellas. A woman gives birth to a baby boy. 7 days, any blood she sees is Tame. The next 33 days, even though she's bleeding, that's Dam Torah. That's Dam Torah. A female, 14 days is Dam Tamei. Next 66 days is Dam Torah. We have Machlokes in Nida, whether you have to be stopped or not, whether it's the same fountain or a different fountain, Machlokes, Rav, and I forgot, probably Shmuel. And anyway, L'chol HaPachas, at the end of 40 days, the 41st, so you could be living with her on the 40th day, only 41, right? Then you're so used to living with Dam, we say separate, because you never know, because if she sees Dam on that day, that's Dam Nida. So therefore, that day for anointing for 12 hours, you should go ahead right and separate. Day 41 and day 81. Tana, who Yosef, a whole list of names, this guy has a bunch of names. Tana, who Yosef Ish Hutzel, who Yosef Abavli, who Isi ben Gur Aryeh, who Isi ben Yehuda, who Isi ben Gamliel, who Isi ben Mahalalel, Uma Shmo, Isi ben Akavya Shmo. Rabbi Yitzchak ben Tavla, who Rabbi Yitzchak ben Chaklo, who Rabbi Yitzchak ben Ilah, who Amon Aleph Rabbi Yitzchak ben Acha, the Shmaitza, so who Rabbi Yitzchak ben Pinchas Agarata. So anytime the Gemara says Rabbi Yitzchak, guys, it's Rabbi Yitzchak Acha. When it says Agarata, Rabbi Pinchas, it's Rabbi Yitzchak ben Pinchas. Simunecha, Shimuno Achai Vareoi. Shimu is the Lashon of Gemara, and Shimuno Achai Vareoi, Acha is the Lashon of Acha. So you know it's what? It's Rabbi Yitzchak ben Acha. It's mnemonic to remember which Yitzchak. Amar Rabbi Chanan Rabbi Yochanan, Mishmeid Rabbi Yochanan, Bar Eloi, Ochel Botzel, Veshav Betzel, eat an onion and sit in the shadows. You know, it's eat very, very meaning, limit your intake of food. V'leitechel avozim b'tarnagoylim, ducks, geese, or chicken. You should not get used to that. Libcha roidef alecha. That you shouldn't get used to eating good because then you're going to be chasing after your bat all your days. So eat, don't eat such a expensive good food. Again, those days it was much more expensive than now. Milkecha umashticha, go ahead. Roidef alecha. Pachas min milkecha umashticha v'toysev al dirasecha. Eat less, drink less, and spend more money in your house. Kiyasu ulo omar. Mitlot maslin. I'll give you a mushel. Again, in Aramaic, I once told you, often you take the tough and you make it into a shin, like tlas is shalosh, talga is shelig, tbats matlis maslin is mushel and mushel, right? It's like a mushel. Go say, make a mushel. Marova, in the ochel, in Eretz Yisrael, they said the following mushel. Kiyasa ula omar, the ochel al yalta, toshi bal alalta. Someone who eats al yalta, he eats the fat. He's used to eating fat. Then Toshi Azalia will be smeared in fat. The Ochel Kilkule, he eats vegetables, right? Then Akule the Masa Shochib, he'll be able to sit in the garbage dump in the city. He'll be able to, in front of everybody and not be what, and no one will cover him anything. In other words, if you eat an Alia, if you eat fat, you're going to be hiding in your attic because the people are going to come claim from you. Right. Because you get used to spending, needing money to go ahead and feed your, literally your habit. On the other hand, if you're not used to eating such expensive stuff, you can be in the middle of a place and no one's going to bother you whatsoever. Good evening to all.